Coralline algae is a type of encrusting red algae that contains calcareous deposits within its cell walls. It forms on rocks, pumps, and tank glass, and although it's classified as red algae, it's most commonly purple, lilac, and pink when it grows on our tanks. Some species can also be yellow, blue, or gray-green in color. It grows in all the world's oceans and is an important part of the marine ecosystem. In the wild, coralline algae is an important reef builder, fusing rocks and dead coral skeletons together, and even forming its own rocks as layer and layer encrust over the reef over time. Creatures eat it too, like parrotfish and sea urchins, powdering it up and in turn contributing to coral and sand layers and new calcareous base rocks as it gets compressed down and covered over millennia. When it grows in the right place, like on your rock structure, coralline is a desirable algae, and a reef tank with lots of coralline growth is also a sign that it is mature and has good water chemistry for growing corals. It also provides surface areas for beneficial bacterial growth, and coral frags take readily to its surface when stuck to it. Here are some ways that you can encourage it. Coralline algae like the same water conditions that corals do. So that includes stable salinity, pH, alkalinity, calcium, magnesium, as well as the other important trace elements. Coralline algae won't grow if DKH, calcium, and magnesium are too low. So test your water, and if your parameters aren't at least as high as natural seawater, use buffers and water changes to bring those levels back up. Here are the levels that all reefers should aim for healthy corals. They're also necessary to encourage and maintain coralline algae growth. Check your salinity too, as it will be difficult to manage chemistry if your water isn't at the correct levels. You can also add supplements that are specifically targeted to boost coralline algae growth. Although we recommend that they are combined with the relevant DKH, calcium, and magnesium test kits so that you have a better idea of how much to add and when, as they contain buffers too. And if you want to give your coralline a turbo boost, increase pH and alkalinity using calc phosphor and a calcium reactor, and you should see some crazy bright pink coralline in no time. I'll say, taking shortcuts always comes with some risk, so we only recommend this to experienced reefers who know how to manage the effects that this can have on their animals. Phosphate and nitrate can retard coralline algae growth and encourage fast-growing nuisance algae, which will smother it and prevent it from finding a clean surface to become established on. Use a phosphate reactor, algae scrubber, refugium, or probiotics to keep those nutrients consistently low, starving the nuisance algae while providing opportunity for coralline algae to take root. Your corals will thank you for it too. Coralline algae loves blue and violet light spectrums between 435 and 380 nanometers, so use a combination of blue and violet LEDs or actinic T5 lamps to really encourage its growth. It doesn't need bright light and will often grow on the back of the tank and in areas that are almost shaded, but it does need the right spectrum of light to truly flourish. So treat coralline algae just like hard coral, with good light, water chemistry, and low nutrients in the tank, and it'll grow in no time, encrusting everything in the tank and making your reef tank look more like a slice of nature and a well-established marine ecosystem. Do all of these things and it should just appear and start growing on its own. But there's nothing better than introducing some coralline algae fragments to start it growing in your tank and give you a head start. Use cured live rock that is already encrusted with pink and purple coralline algae to introduce it to your tank, or deliberately select coral colonies with pink and purple encrusted bases at your local fish store. You could also find a fellow reefer who has some and scrape some off their glass with a razor blade. Use coral glue to stick fragments purple side up to your rocks, and it should start to spread and colonize in no time. And if you want to achieve maximum unhindered coralline growth, we recommend that you leave out the sea urchins. Although brilliant algae eaters, they also consume coralline algae and will leave a trail of coralline-free, new-looking rock in their wake. And although few tanks are large enough to house them, leave out parrotfish too. But if you just want the simple life with purple rocks and no fuss, don't worry, the hobby can cater to you too. Artificial reef rocks are available in pinks and purples to simulate that reef look. They're suitable for fish only or reef tanks and provide that instant coralline algae look without the hassle. But how much is too much? You'll soon know that some of the places that coralline algae appears are on your overflow combs and plastic pump cages. It can negatively affect pump performance if it starts to encrust over the inlets, so use pump cleaner to remove it and make your pumps look and perform like new again. And not every reefer likes to have coralline algae growing on the back glass, especially if they have an open, minimalist scape with a black or clear background. To remove coralline algae from those areas, use a long reach scraper or use an algae magnet with a blade, and it will come off by applying some gentle pressure. With a little bit of regular maintenance, you'll have this algae in precisely the places that you want and cleared away from the places you don't. We really hope you found this information helpful. If you have any other useful tips, please consider dropping them in the comments section below. They may just help someone that is struggling to establish algae in their tank. That's all we have for today. Feel free to like and share this video if you find it useful. Subscribe to our channel and click that bell to receive notifications when we release new videos. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to share this beautiful hobby with someone you love.